Hello and welcome. In the previous lecture, we have verified that our AWS user can access S3 from the command line and have set up the necessary properties in the application common properties file. In this lecture, we will be implementing a Spring S3 service to store our user account images during the signup process. The goal is to store the S3 URL for a profile image in the user's record. We will start by making sure that we are pointing at the S3 branch with the git command git checkout S3. Now, we will add a new property to the application common properties file. This property contains the root path to a temporary folder where we will be temporarily storing images before uploading them to S3. We will call this property image.store.tmp.folder and assign to it the value userHome/DevOpsBuddy/temp/assets. Next, we will add a few new dependencies to the POM XML file. First, we will add the AWS SDK dependency. This allows us to use the AWS SDK programmatically. The Maven group ID is com.amazonaws, the artifact ID is AWS Java SDK, and the version is latest, all in uppercase. Next, we will add the Commons I/O dependency as we want to use its filename utils to extract the extension from a filename. Both group and artifact IDs are Commons I/O and the dependency is latest, all in uppercase. Now, we will need to declare an Amazon S3 client bin. We can do this in the application config class. First, we auto-wire the property that identifies the AWS profile that we want to use. The property name value comes from the application common.properties file. The property name that we pass to the @value annotation is aws.s3.profile. Then we define an S3 client method that returns an Amazon S3 client type and annotate it with the @bin annotation. Inside the method, we create an AWS credentials object based on the profile credentials provider class, to which we pass our profile instance variable as parameter. We then use this credentials object to create an Amazon S3 client object. Then we set the region for this client to be EU West 1, which is where I've created my bucket. If you have used another region, you might want to change that to your value. To find out your region, you can Google for AWS regions and availability zones and follow from there. Finally, we return the Amazon S3 client. Now, we can write the S3 service. We can right-click on the service package, select New, Class, and name it S3 service. As usual, we annotate it with the @service annotation. However, in this case, we won't need to use any @transactional annotations, as we won't be interacting with the database. I'm now going to copy this class implementation from the code that I've prepared for this lecture, and then I'll talk you through it. First, we have declared an SLF4J logger to help operations. Then, we have declared the constant profile picture filename with value profile picture. We will use this constant to name both the temporary file that we will be storing locally and the S3 file that we will be uploading to Amazon S3. Then we have declared three properties whose values we have defined in the application common.properties file. These are the bucket name, the AWS profile name, and the location of temporary folder where to store S3 asset. Next, we have auto-wired the Amazon S3 client bin that we have just declared in the application config class. The class defines a public method storeProfileImage and two private methods, ensureBucket exists and storeProfileImage to S3. StoreProfileImage is the method that we will be invoking from the signup controller. It accepts a multipart file and the username. We will use the username to name the folder within the Amazon S3 bucket. The method creates an array of bytes from the multipart file. It then creates a new file object representing the temporary asset folder plus the username at the end. It then checks if the folder already exists and if it doesn't, he creates it. He then creates a full path to the temporary file that contains the image. The file is always named profile image and has whatever extension the image that the user uploaded had. He then writes the content of the uploaded file to this temporary file. Finally, it invokes the private method storeProfileImage to S3, passing in the full path to the temporary file just written and the username. This method delegates to the ensureBucketExists method the task to make sure that the bucket whose name we have defined in the properties file exists. The ensureBucketExists method uses the Amazon S3 client to check whether the bucket exists, and if it doesn't, it creates one, returning the URL where the bucket is located. The storeProfileImageToS3 method then checks the return value to make sure the bucket was created, and if it was, it creates an access control list object granting all users read permissions. It then composes a key with the username, a forward slash, the word profile picture, a dot, and the extension of whatever file the user uploaded. It then invokes the Amazon S3 client putObject method, passing as argument a new putObjectRequest object constructed with the bucket name, the key, and the access control list. This effectively results in S3 creating a new folder under the bucket, which, as name, has got the username and under it a file named profilePicture. And whatever extension. Finally, this method invokes the Amazon S3 client getResourceURL method, passing in the bucket name and the key and returns it this value. The URL returned by getResourceURL is the full URL to the image stored in the S3 bucket. If you print it out via a log message or by debugging the application and try the URL on the browser, it should display the image that the user uploaded as part of the signup process. The last thing we need to do before closing this journey is to invoke this service from the signup controller. First, we auto-wire the S3 service that we have just created. Then, we locate the point where, in the previous lecture, we have assigned the value null to the variable profile image URL and replace the assignment with the invocation of the S3 service store profile image to which we pass the multipart file object and the username contained within the payload object. If we restart the application now and go through the basic subscription journey, uploading a picture, upon visiting our bucket in S3, we should see that a new folder named as the username has been created. If we then inspect it, we will see that a profile picture.extension image has been created. In my case, the extension was JPG. We can select it and choose Open to see if the picture has been uploaded successfully. Congratulations! You have learned how to interact with S3 programmatically. In this course, we have only skimmed the surface of S3. For example, we haven't discussed how to host static websites, how to restrict access to resources through temporary URLs, how to set security programmatically through policies, and much more. S3 is one of AWS' oldest and therefore more mature services, and it provides plenty of functionality. If you want to know more, you can browse the online documentation. The last thing we need to do is to close the Git flow workflow. First, we push the local changes remotely with the git commands git add star, git commit -m completed the S3 service, and git push. Then we can merge to develop with the git commands git checkout develop, git merge S3, and finally git push. This lecture concludes the basic account creation journey and this section. In the next section, we will be looking at credit card processing with Stripe and to add a pro subscription capability to our website. Thank you for your time, and I see you in the next lecture.